No, I'm about to go in. Told me that I couldn't do it, but I gotta bring it back. So they're really numb with it.
Let's go.
Tell me where you're from, where you stay. Now I keep it lit from the coast to the bay. Peace on the right.
If you guys are looking to get cheap and instant Madden 18 coins, be sure to head over to muckcoinbank.com and use promo code MAZE at checkout for 10% off. What is going on, you guys? Mazomatic here with the final episode of my weekend league recap from last weekend. This is games 21 through 25. I am 16-4 currently. You're looking at the team. Nothing has changed. It's the exact same squad. And these are some freaking hitters, baby. These guys go so hard. You see my record right here, 16-4. Going into game 21, if I want to be in the top 100, I need to go at least 4-1 because I need 20 wins to be in the top 100. So to start, we're going to be going against the Hood's finest. And we'll see if he really is the finest the Hood has to offer. But he's starting with the ball, 2nd and 10. We send heaters off the edge. Ray Lewis getting a sack as usual. 3rd and 15, he finds a low pass and ends up completing that pass. And now it's 4th and 2, but the user there on the run defense. I fill the hole with Willie McGinnis, and we end up getting a turnover on downs, which is the way I love to start games. So our first offensive drive, we're starting from the 25, already almost inside the red zone. I checked it down on a drag route, and watch this. That, oh, my God. I didn't know why I threw that, man. I gotta be honest, that play that I run right there, that play action play, 50% of the time it's a touchdown, 50% of the time it's like an interception. So he fires right back with an interception. Night train lane, playing the cloud flat perfectly, gonna get it for a pick six. Just kidding, I'm a freaking idiot and I ran out of bounds. But thick boy Dante doesn't care. He wants the touchdown himself, gonna QB sneak it in for a touchdown. So now we're up 7-0, his ball again. He gets a huge run to Bo Jackson. We end up stopping him around the 29-yard line, and but he is in the red zone. I don't remember this guy having a very good red. Yeah. Oh my God! As I'm watching this, I'm getting pissed. That was a cloud flat cover two. And if you throw it right on the break, it like doesn't cover. I don't know how that happened. But Bo Jackson's pissed off that the game just glitched us out like that. So he's gonna come and take it for a touchdown. You know that roid rage is really strong, and he returns a kick for a touchdown right after that to regain our 7-point lead. Bo Jackson, I love you, buddy. Celebrate in the end zone. Let's go. We got the 7-point lead. 2 minutes left in the first half, and it's his ball again. He is looking to throw. Swatted. Intercepted. Telvin Smith with the hands. Tip drill, baby. I love it. Deion Jones with that 91 zone out middle linebacker always makes a ton of plays over the middle. Just come through, swat the ball. Bo Jackson still pissed off, still got the roid rage, and he's taking it 41 yards for another touchdown. We are now up by 14 with 30 seconds left in the first half. This dude is dropping back. He's going to throw it into double coverage, and for some reason, my guys did not respond to the ball. I don't know what happened there, but he catches it at the 12-yard line. So with 13 seconds left, he is trying to score a touchdown. No one's open. He tries to throw it late. I don't know what throw that was. Calvin Johnson comes down with the interception. So end of the first half, I'm up by 14. We get the ball to start the second half. He's in a cover three, and I got the one play touchdown. I toss it up. Thick boy Dante cocks back. Calvin Johnson catches it. Goes out of bounds at the 2-yard line. But it does not matter because Bo Jackson wants his third touchdown of the day. Is that his third touchdown of the game? I think so. So now we are up by 21. I really wish this guy would have quit, but he did not. We got Ray Lewis coming in and smacking his quarterback on a sack. And Night Train Lane recovers a fumble. I literally was already up by 21. All I did was run the ball 3 times right up the middle and then chew clock and kick my field goal. I was not really trying to, you know, play. But inside the 20, and again, he throws a really bad read. He could not finish in the red zone. I noticed that about this guy. He turned the ball over like 3 times inside the 20-yard line. So that was unfortunate for him. But like I said again, I just ran the ball 3 times, chewed clock, and then punted it right back to him because I was over it. He tries to fake out my user, but we get the user lurk across the middle. He did like a little stop and go route by his receiver, and I just followed it the whole way. And I'm a scumbag, so with 2 seconds remaining, I just throw a streak with 2 seconds remaining, and look what happens. Dwight Clark, almost said Dallas Clark. Dwight Clark comes down with it, and we score because I'm the biggest scumbag in the world. Going into the next game against Soul Rebel 71. So now we are, 17-4? So now we got 4 more games remaining. Going against Soul Rebel 21. I got the ball first, and we convert on 4th down. That was a little risky. I wasn't even induced close, but I go with the same formation right after that and run the same play. This time I wait a little bit, find the in route, get down, spin move inside the 5-yard line. He got popped, but he held on to it. So now from the 5-yard line, you know what we do. Bo Jackson getting in there, man. Bo Jackson is scoring so many touchdowns for me, dude. Like anytime I get inside the red zone, oh my God, Jalen Ramsey, you took that man's life. But Bo Jackson, anytime I get inside the 10-yard line, I run the ball out with Bo Jackson. But as you see, this guy ran a lot of C routes, and he ran the ball a lot. But we got him into a third and goal. We stopped him inside the 10, 8-yard line. He's looking to score, throws a high pass right over Willie McGinnis' head, gets down to the 1-yard line, but decides to kick his field goal instead of going for it, which is fine. I'm happy with that because that means we're having a 4-point lead with the ball with 2 minutes remaining. So it's my ball back. I'm trying to run this one play touchdown, not seeing anybody, but Randy Moss cuts inside. We throw it to him, and he gets a solid gain of like 25. But like I said before, guys, when I run this play action play, I throw a lot of freaking interceptions, and that's what just happened right there. So he gets an interception with about 25 seconds left in the first half. We get him into the third and 10. He tries to throw it to the sideline, overthrown a bit, and he's going to punt it back to me with 7 seconds. Now watch this. I roll out to the right. I see triangle. Dante Culpepper, thick boy with the dot. Get down to the 34, 2 seconds remaining, out of bounds, and we kick our field goal to take a full 7-point lead. So going into the next half, it's his ball. But we have a full touchdown lead, which I'm happy about because my defense is playing really well too. We got him in a third and 10. I send heat. He blocks it. Ends up dotting me up across on an in route from the outside receiver, getting the first down. Second and 8 next. And what? I don't even know what happens here. He throws it right over my head, man. Oh my God. 6'5", Willie McGinnis. Wish he would have jumped up for that. But it is okay. Third and 8. He's going to get popped and end up taking his field goal. I don't know why I cut it out. But so now we're up by 4 points. And he got me in a fourth down. I threw it and did not possession catch it. So I got popped and dropped the ball. Turnover on downs. We have him in a third down. User lurk, Willie McGinnis. That's the animation I needed. Not over your head this time, buddy. But up by 4, our ball again. I go back to this one play touchdown. I think he's in a cover 4. He was using the safety. And you see Calvin Johnson got behind him. At that point, it was too late. Nothing you could do. And I just threw it over the top for a one play touchdown once again. You guys have probably noticed that this week in league, I threw so many one-play touchdowns. It was ridiculous. But 2:22 left. We're up by 2 possessions. I was really just, you know, he went for it on fourth down inside the 10, ended up converting, ended up having to kick a field goal. So now we're up by 8, and now I'm just trying to chew out the clock, okay? So second and 6, I get one first down, the game's over. I get the first down, the game's over. So instead of taking a knee, I decide to run the ball. I don't know why. And of course, Bo Jackson's going to fumble. And I swear to God, dude, I thought that guy was going to take it for 6, and I was about to be so scared. But he did not, thankfully. So, 4th down and 10, he converts. He's got 37 seconds left, no timeouts. He needs to score and get the 2-point conversion. So, I'm still feeling confident, okay? He throws it up. That was actually a good read, but Night Train Lane is there to break up the pass. 3rd and 5, he tries that out route again. We got boys there this time, and they hit the ball out. Incomplete pass, 4th down. 22 seconds left. I do think he converts right here. Yeah, he playmakers up. Barely squeezes it in there to Rob Gronkowski. Converts. So with 3 seconds left, he's going to throw it up. And we got boys there, and we hit the ball out. And that is going to do it for that game. So now we are 18-4. I have 3 games remaining. Going against the Big Mean Possum, who has a really good team. He's got Mel Blunt, Sean Taylor. Oh, my goodness. 4th and 5 to start against him. I send crazy heat. We got, oh, wow, the user was there. I was going to say we got boys there, but I guess it didn't matter. He wanted to catch it over me. So 3rd and 1, he goes with a fullback dive, and then he hurries up, goes right to the fullback dive again, gets another solid, like, 8-9 yards. Geez, just fighting down. And then he tries to run this power O and gets smacked by Ray Lewis. Big hitter fumble. We recover. Let's go. Good way to start the game. And, of course, I'm going with this one play touchdown. Wow, okay. Dante Culpepper almost got, like, hit right as he threw it. Like, he pretty much did get hit right as he threw it. But I had a guy wide open, Randy Moss, and I threw it to him and got the touchdown. So, great way to start the game with a fumble and then a one-play touchdown. And then we get crazy pressure in there and hit his quarterback really freaking hard. And on 4th and 10, he's going for the same high pass he got last time. But this time, I got an animation to get a stop. And from there, I think he kind of gave up at this point. He was just, like, blitzing everyone. I think he thought I was going to run it. So I just threw it in for a touchdown. I could tell this guy was done. So he decided to quit. I said, boy, get off my field. Get off my field, okay? 100% completion, 100 yards, 2 touchdowns. Get off my field. Next, if you guys remember this opponent. Wow, look at that team. Really good team right there. If you guys remember this opponent, Yanks 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 0, 3, 9, 0, 9. My screen's kind of blurry. I can't read the number. We played this guy last weekend, and this guy is a top 100 really good opponent. And he loves to pitch the ball. He loves to run the ball. As you're going to see, that's pretty much like his offense. And I don't blame him. I posted that on my channel a while ago. Said that was like the best run scheme. And I agree. I think it is. So he's running this. Breaks a crazy tackle with Barry Sanders. Gets to the outside and ends up taking it all the way for touchdown. So he had 3 pretty big runs. And that's how he drove down and scored. That kind of annoyed me. So I was like, hey, I'm going to fire back with this one play tutty. And he blitzed like straight up everyone. So I had to quickly get rid of the ball and say, oh, double spin move. Oh my God, Randy Moss. Stop and go? No, I couldn't complete the stop and go. But double spin move, had to check it down to Randy Moss. And then from there, we get a pretty nice run right here to Bo Jackson. Truck the air, make a miss, get down inside the 10. And from here, I like this goal line glitch play. Might be on the channel soon. Watch this. Nothing you can do to stop that without a user. Unless you have your user over in the corner of the end zone, you can't really stop it. So that, I love that play. We're starting to figure out how to beat his toss also. You know, I'm starting to slowly learn how to box toss. And oh my God, I thought Deion Jones hit that out, man. Third and six here with the toss again. Night Train in there with the hit. And he takes his field goal, settling for three. Going to take a 10-7 lead, 2 minutes remaining in the first half. My ball, first and five. What am I going to do? Throw an interception. Are you kidding me? Honestly, he wasn't even usering that guy either, which annoys me. Because the guy that I threw to was like 10 yards downfield. He wasn't even meaning to user him. It's just he got that crazy animation. I don't know what happened. Boom, but I fire right back. User lurk of my own. User lurk of my own, baby. Willie McGinnis. I think I've had like 6 user lurks already in these past few games. 1 minute remaining. My ball. He's got no timeouts. And I'm just, you know, I'm trying to make something happen. I find a corner route. Let's go. 40 seconds. We get down to the 3-yard line. And from here, you know what I do. I run it up the middle with Bo Jackson. And we're going to score and take a 4-point lead. So with 19 seconds remaining, this is unbelievable. This is a deep. This is a cover 2 with a deep blue. He gets it. Oh my God. Shoestring tackle from Deion Jones. That would have been a touchdown. He has no timeouts, so he tries to get in field goal formation really quick and ends up running out of time. So he did not even get a field goal out of that. That was wild, though. That was a cover 2 with a deep blue. I did not know he was going to be able to beat that. He goes with a cover 2 of his own, and I find Calvin Johnson over the middle, going to squiggle a little bit between his safeties and get in for a touchdown. So now we're up by 11. 2 possessions. I'm feeling confident in the third quarter. I know at this point I can kind of chew clock and stuff, and then Jalen Ramsey essentially seals the game with that interception right there, because now we're up by 2 possessions. My ball, whatever. Oh no, stupid me. I'm gonna go with a 1-play touchdown. I have no idea why I did that. He intercepts it. I don't know why I went with a 1-play touchdown, but it's gonna be his ball again. 2nd and 15. We got boys coming. Get the sack. That was a big sack. So now it is gonna be 3rd and long, and he ended up having to punt it after that. Punts it back to us. Bo Jackson gonna get the ball and try to get free. We get down to the 1-yard line. There's 2 minutes left. So at this point, I'm just, you know, I'm going to run the ball in and just chew clock. The game's basically over at that point. 4th and 8 for him with 1 minute remaining. I'm up by 3 possessions, so I'm not really worried about anything. 4th and 8, and like I said, he takes a shot downfield. Larry Wilson playing center field, gets an interception. And from there, I just ran the clock out. You know, I wasn't going to do any showboating stuff against this guy, but final game. I now have 20 wins. I'm 20-4. This is the final game. I can't even read this guy's name. Bulldog something, I think. I don't know. The screen is blurry that I'm recording this on. To start out the game, I get a counter. I get a really big run on that, so I'm driving pretty well on this guy. We're getting inside the red zone, inside the 25, and I decide to go with the high pass right here, and I don't know what happened. I did a high pass, and it said touch pass. Like, it lobbed it, and then he got the interception. I don't know what that was all about. That was really weird. But so he's getting a turnover to start, but this dude just kept running this toss. But it was not working. We had the defense for it. 2nd and 4, he runs a toss again. And we are still there once again. So now it is 3rd and 7. We're sending a lot of heat at this guy. And it is going to come screaming off the edge. And we're going to get the sack. And he's going to have to punt it to us. Nope, he's going to go for it on 4th and 14. This guy with no offense is going to go for it on 4th and 14. Willie McGinnis, perfect timing user pick. I don't know why I didn't say user lurk. I was on him the whole time, so I don't know why I didn't give me the user lurk, but another user lurk for Willie McGinnis. Now we are inside the 10 again, and I'm just going to run it this time. I'm not going to try any high passes because I don't know what's going to happen, man. I don't want to throw any interceptions. So we get the touchdown pretty easy, just, you know, ran it up the middle. This guy throws it right at my user again, Willie McGinnis, with another user lurk. Can I take this one for 6? No, I cannot. Dante Culpepper making a tackle. He ends up holding me at the 1-yard line, but being a smart football player, I decide to take my 3 points, go up by 2 possessions towards the end of the first half. I think I'm getting the ball at half also. So there's only 15 seconds left. This guy's just checking it down. I don't really know what he's doing. But 4th and 13. Yeah, what are you doing, dude? Okay, so we ended up getting another user lurk. That's the 3rd one this half. I don't know why this guy went for it. But we couldn't actually get 3 points out of it, which it would have been nice if we did. But coming out, first play of the second half, he gets a freaking 77-yard run to Bo Jackson, which was nice. He had a nice, you know, little juke move, whatever. I try to fire right back, and I think it's going to work. Yeah, oh my God, wide open. On the run, under pressure, off his back foot, Dante Culpepper. Look at the throw. That's why he's a thick boy. Like, that is why he's a thick boy right there, just for that. Good job, Dante, man. Oh my goodness. Third and nine. I'm up by 10 points. We end up tackling him. He's going to take his three to make it a one-possession ball game, and he misses the field goal in the third quarter. That's pretty much a death sentence right there. That put the nail in the coffin. I don't know how he got the ball back. I must have just... Oh, I think I just chewed the clock and then punted it back to him. We get him in a 4th and 13, and we send crazy heat. We end up getting a sack. Now we're in field goal range. I just chewed clock again. Kick my field goal again. 2:30 left in the game. In order to be 21-4, I really need it, boys. He is just running the ball, too. I don't understand why. Like, okay, I get it. You get a couple good runs. But, like, you're down by 13 points. Like, I would not be running the ball under 2 minutes to go in the game. You got to be just passing it, going deep and stuff like that. But 1:22 left. We destroy him and end up picking up the fumble. We didn't return it for anything. But at that point, he had no timeouts. So we just could just chew the clock and stuff like that. Chew the clock down. Finished 21-4, ranked 45 inside the top 100. I love it. Top 50 for the week. I love it. I got my rewards video. I already recorded that. That is going to be up like literally right after this video. So if you want to see my rewards, just stay tuned. It's going to be posted probably 30 to 40 minutes after this video, if even that. But you see, rank 45, 21-4. I was pretty proud of myself. I could have gone 23-2, I bet. We'll see what happens this weekend, how I do this weekend. But I was proud of myself, ranked 45. And as I said in the past ones, I'm going to be reading a funny comment that I thought was hilarious. Carter Webster 2 just commented, thick boy Dante with two C's in a space. I don't know, that this comment made me laugh. Like, I was like laughing out loud when I read this. Legitimately, I thought that was hilarious. I don't know why that made me laugh so hard, but it did. Thick boy Dante, MVP. Thank you, Carter. If you guys want one of your comments to be read, just comment something funny down below. And if I think it's funny, I will be reading it in my next video. If you guys like the video, be sure to leave a like down below. If you want to see my rewards, leave a like down below. And also, if you really want to see this weekend's weekend league game in the same format that I did last weekend's, if you want to see me do that for this upcoming weekend, leave it down in the comments below and I will definitely take it into consideration. But with that said, you guys, I'll be seeing you in the next video.